Already Columbus had the order to establish some Spanish colonies in what would later be called the West Indies or Caribbean. The first colony became Hispaniola with the first fort called La Navidad, Spanish for Christmas, which was built by Columbus and his crew out of his flagship Santa Maria. Columbus left 39 crew members in La Navidad and continued his discovery of the Caribbean islands. But most probably, the left Spanish sailors broke out in dispute with the natives and got killed or deported in the center of the island. Columbus found just ruins and dead corpses when he came back on his second voyage. The Spanish tried to establish some new settlements on Hispaniola and finally succeeded in the foundation of Santo Domingo, which is the capital of the Dominican Republic today. The Spanish hoped to find gold and silver on the islands, but instead of big amounts of gold and some new spices, the Spanish importantly found out that the climate in the Caribbean was perfect to grow sugarcane. They imported the plant to the New World and wanted to use the natives as slaves on the plantations. But the Indians died from the strain of their work and from diseases the Europeans had brought to the New World. When Columbus arrived at his first voyage, about 1 million Indians were living in the Caribbean. Diseases and the hard treat by the Spanish let the population of natives shrink in a few decades to a few thousand. To fix the problem of the slaves, the Europeans imported some black African slaves to the Caribbean who were forced to work on the plantations. But the avarice of the Spanish pushed them from the West Indies to the continent, which seemed to hide more wealth than the Caribbean. The Spanish West Indies became just a foothold in America, from which the conquistadores went to expeditions and conquests. The West Indies were an important bridgehead in America. The Spanish won't give up for centuries.